Hello students, welcome to Science Plus TV once again. Today I have come up with a topic of class 9 and it's really interesting. The Rutherford model of atom. Here in this video, I will discuss with you the experiment that was carried out by Rutherford to give his, very much accepted views about the structure of atom. So what he did basically, he took alpha particles. And alpha particles are what? These are helium-2 positive ions actually. And for further experiments, he chose a very thin gold foil in which the atoms could have this kind of arrangement where they were having nucleus at the center. For his experiment, he chose the gold foil because the gold metal has tremendous amount of malleability. It can be beaten into a very very thin sheet, highly malleable metal. So he took a very fine foil of gold metal, and this foil was thick 1000 atoms. Means the thickness was such that 1000 atoms were covered in the thickness of that gold foil. Now what he did basically, he bombarded the alpha particles over it. He bombarded the alpha particles on the very thin gold foil. Now let's discuss what he found. He found that most of the alpha particles, they passed straight without any deflection. Very few of them deflected through small angles. Very few of them deflected through small angles. But there are rare chances where the alpha particle completely turned back. So these were the three important findings of this Rutherford's experiment. Now we shall discuss what these observations interfer. So now let's discuss the inference of his experiment as number one. Most alpha particles passed straight. So that means most of the space inside the atom is empty. It interfered lots of empty space within the atom. Now, very few alpha particles deflected through small angles. That showed to him that the center, the positive charge inside the atom is located in a very small space. Okay, this interfered that positive charge is confined to a small space. inside the atom. That means that positive charge is present within a very small area inside the atom. Let's discuss the third one. Very few deflected back. They straight collided with the center of the atom, and then they collide. They returned back completely at the angle of 0 degree. Okay, so that showed to him that whole of the mass and charge, the charge, positive charge, is located at the center. Okay, so these were the three important findings of his experiments and their inferences, what we inferred out of these findings. Okay children, I hope it will help you to understand the Rutherford's experiment and his findings too. Let me tell you about its demerits also, because he said that lots of space is empty. So out of these findings he inferred a particular type of structure where he said that the nucleus is at the center with whole of the positive charge and most of the mass, and electrons are negatively charged particles. They keep revolving around the nucleus in the space around the nucleus. But when he was asked that why the electron is not, sorry, this was not the structure proposed by him, he said that the mass and positive charge is located at the center and electron revolves around the nucleus. Okay, but when he was asked, okay, see, because electron is negatively charged, nucleus is positively charged, and nucleus is having a lots of charge. So basically, electron should get attracted towards the nucleus, and while taking rounds around the nucleus, it should ultimately come and fell inside the nucleus. This must be there. But when he was asked this question, he was unable to answer. He couldn't justify it, that why electron does not fall into the nucleus while it is revolving around the nucleus. Okay, so this demerit led to the model, the Bohr model of atom, which we accept nowadays, which I will discuss in my later videos. Thank you so much, everybody.